Welcome everyone to your reading. I'm going to be checking out what the energy oracle has to say for all of you and what the energy is around you. What are you manifesting? Let's bring forward a message from your spirit guides. So let's see if this could be about anything. Let's see about this. Let's see what the message is coming forward. This could be about your spiritual evolution, love, finances. It always changes up. Here, let's... That one popped out. Hope everybody's doing well. Let's leave this one over here. I'll pull three more cards. Spirit, what messages do you want to bring forward for whoever is watching today? What messages... Coming, this one popped out. What messages do you want to bring forward for whoever is watching today? So let's put these here and then two more. And then let's look at the bottom of the deck. We got the thinking man again. That one came out yesterday. All right. Wow. Woman holding a coin. I'm sorry. Heart. Woman holding a heart. Healer of ages. Healer of ages. Contract. Wow. An angel of love and thinking man. Okay. This is very clear. It's a very clear message. Some of you, all right, and with this healer of ages here, many of you here, even though I know yesterday when I was doing the reading, I was, saying that this is a masculine energy, right? This thinking man. It can be, and you know, and again, as it resonates for all of you, even though I will say that it is a masculine energy, or this portrays a man here, this could be towards anybody that's coming into your life. So, you know, so if you are masculine energy looking for love, this can be towards you. This could be applying to you also. So just, you know. All right, so all of you, this is another love reading. Spirit wants to bring, they wanted to talk about love yesterday. They want to talk about love today. Yesterday was distinctly a little bit different. This is definitely very straightforward with the contract here. Healer of ages, a lot of you have gone through intense work, spiritual work with healing your heart chakra, healing your heart center. And you have elevated your frequency. You've elevated yourself. How you felt yourself, your self-image, your self-worth, the self-concept of yourself. You have shifted that entirely. You are no longer the same person that you were before. And the person that you are now is due to the fact of all the intense work that you put into yourself. And this is having to do with, again, kind of like what I was discussing yesterday, how you treat yourself. You put up boundaries, healthy boundaries. And let's say you have, you had promised yourself, and this is another thing, you made promises to yourself, and maybe your past self broke a lot of those promises. Like, oh, I want to get to this weight, or I want to get to this, whatever goal it is that you're putting. Again, it could be different for all of you. And a lot of you would break a lot of those promises to yourself, and it affected your self-esteem, right? Like, am I not able to accomplish things? Am I not able to you know, hold myself accountable? And the way we hold promises to ourselves, hold ourselves accountable, the way we see ourselves can affect all aspects of our life, our career, our sense of stability, security, financial abundance, love. It affects everything when we don't hold ourselves to that high standards and have those healthy boundaries. So a lot of you now, you're like, no, I'm just giving you an example here. I'm going to work out three times a week, whatever. And I don't care what happens, or somebody calls me, or whatever. I am keeping this promise to myself. Or let's say you decided to change the way you eat. You want to eat less meat, or you want to eat less carbs, and you're keeping that promise to yourself. You have a, you're aspiring to become more spiritual, and you're dedicating every morning or every night or a time every day to meditate, to treat yourself, to take care of your spiritual health. Writing things down, doing that shadow work, writing down, you know, what's happened during the day, what triggered you, why do you think that happened? You know, like, again, this could, and sorry that I'm going on a tangent right now, but I just want to emphasize the amount of work and what spirit wants to bring forward for you, how proud they are, how they look at you with this recognition now. They're looking at you with this recognition that look at how much you've accomplished. You should be proud of yourself, and they want you to be proud of you. So you've done a ton of healing yourself. And I want you to take responsibility for the healing that you've done for yourself. And also a lot of you surrounded by spirit, right? And your guides, angels, helping you to heal and helping you along this process, on this journey of healing. But a lot of you have healed your hearts, and because of that, you've elevated yourself the way you see yourself and what you will allow and will not allow into your life anymore. Okay, so for some of you, again, this is going to be different messages for a lot of you. If you are in a relationship right now and everything's going well, like, you know, just putting that caveat there, this relationship is going to the next level. Okay? This person is thinking about you and aspiring to get to the next level. They're going to make a proclamation to you. They're going to make a request of you. This can be engagement for some of you, because I'm seeing here contract becoming official with an engagement possibly for a lot of you. But this definitely has to do with love, with the heart. Okay? So if you are in a relationship, this could be the very much so going into the next level. If some of you are not in a relationship, right? Or you're just speaking to somebody, it's not official, this person's going to ask you to be officially in a relationship with them. They want you to be their girlfriend, their boyfriend. They want you to be with them. They want to officially be in a relationship with you. Okay, and if some of you, if this is, has nothing to do with love and you're not even looking for that, there's going to be a contract or something that you are working on that is very dear to your heart here. And there might be an offer made here, something that's fulfilling to your heart, if this has nothing to do with a relationship. All right, so let's look. I'm going to pull some tarot to get some more messages, but pretty much this is pretty crystal clear here, and I will pull for my lover's oracle as well. Sometimes spirit will talk a lot about inner work that people need to do, and sometimes those readings are not my most favorite readings, that people don't like them as much, but they'll keep on that. And then sometimes they'll want to talk about your finances, and then sometimes they want to talk about love. So a lot of people shifting into that energy here. Let me see. These cards came out. Okay, we got the Devil and we got Ace of Wands here. Definitely with this Ace. Aces always bring new energy, right? And the Wands here. When it comes to regards to love, is definitely intimacy. I don't want to get into too graphic or whatever, but it's definitely intimacy here. Passion, new passion. This is new energy. Sometimes the Ace of Wands can talk about a new idea or something, but this is a new fiery energy coming into your life. And the Wands is that fire energy, the masculine energy too. And we got the Devil here. And the Devil can sometimes also very much so mean passion, right? But also, with the message to be aware of not falling into past ways of thoughts, if you guys understand what I'm saying. Sometimes when we get into let's say we, even though we've done a ton of work, let's say I'm just giving an example. Somebody cheated on us, or we had partners that cheated on us in the past, right? But we've done a lot of work, right? We've healed a lot. We get into a new relationship, even though we've done a lot of that inner work. Sometimes those old feelings, those fears can come up, and it can come in and sabotage that new relationship sometimes. So just be very wary of that, to be careful not to get pulled back into that old, you know, because again, the devil card here, the people are prisoners, but they are able to let themselves go. It's like an addiction here. We could be addicted to old ways of thinking, old ways of being, right? So just be very wary of falling into those negative patterns of thought. That's just one message that they want to bring forward. But again, the devil card does talk about passion also. What other message is spirit for all of? The Hanged Man. This person has been thinking about Page of Swords here. Definitely messages here. You got Page of Wands here also. The Hanged Man. What I'm seeing here with this is sometimes it can mean like somebody like holding back and maybe hesitating, or sometimes it can mean complacency, but also it can mean waiting until the right time to make that decision, like stepping back, looking at things from a different angle. So what I'm getting here is this person that you're involved with, they're waiting till the right time to make this approach to you, to make this request of you to like talk about this relationship, because we got the Six of Wands here. They're wanting to make it a thing in a way. So I don't know if you guys like might go on a trip or something, but this is the card of recognition, like people like seeing you in a good light, eyes on you, right? There's something about this here, and Page of Swords. Again, that messages. This person is communication here. And I don't know why I'm looking at that hot air balloon behind. There's a trip coming. There's something that maybe they're going to ask you to go on a trip with them, so they can talk about this next leveling up of the relationship. Or talking about the relationship. This person wants to have something official here. They've been holding back though. Anything else? We got Page of Wands again. Pages, you're getting a lot of pages here. Messages. It can also mean youthful energy as well. For some of you, this is definitely a message coming forward. They're going to be speaking to you, communicating things to you with regards to this. But for some of you, you may have children involved in this situation, and you or this person have children, and they want to discuss how you can make things official and blend your families together. And they might request this by asking me, like, do you guys want to take a trip together? Like, all of us together. That's the message I'm getting. That may be very specifically for one person here. Let's look at the love, the romance and love oracle. Healing has come to you, though. Contracts. You're shifting into a new phase of your life, all of you. And if this is not about love, this is messages, a new contract regarding something that's very close to your heart. And with the devil card, sometimes when it comes to business, is talking about making lots of money also. Spirit, what other messages do you want to bring forward for them? Passion. Keep the flame of passion alive. It is the heartbeat of love. What was I talking about? Passion here. Passion. There's a lot of energy in this relationship. True love here. A deep and enduring connection going beyond superficial attraction. That's what I'm telling you. This person is feeling very deep feelings for you. And they see you in their future. They want to embrace this situation that you have and make it official. They want to make you theirs. They want to be yours. Make time to be with your hideaway. Make time to be with your person. Create your own special hideaway. I'm telling you, this person's going to ask you to go on a trip with them to make this official. They want to do something special for you. They're going to make something big out of it, though. Well, I'm excited for you guys. At the bottom of the deck, we have romance. Romantic surprises are on the horizon. Be open to them. All of you, this is your message. A new relationship for many of you. Somebody that's been having their eye on you. Asking you to maybe go on dates. They want to definitely, they're definitely interested in you. For those of you that are in a relationship, they want to level this relationship up and make things more official. If this is not a relationship, something that's very close to your heart. There's a lot of fire and passion here. Okay? And you'll be making money as well. And for a lot of you, a trip coming forward. Okay, this is your messages for today. I hope you all enjoyed it. I send you all tons of love. I'll see you all soon. Bye now.